I have shot using celluloid, and perhaps I ought to say from the beginning that I'm not a practical filmmaker, but I've done some filming largely with students while I've been teaching. So basically, that's most of my experience. Yes, I did do celluloid shooting in the 1970s, 1980s. Yeah.
No, I haven't had a chance.
No, I haven't had the chance to.
From a practical filmmaker's point of view, none. They're painful, it's slow work. From a teaching point of view, one of the major disadvantages is you shoot the film, you send it away to the lab and it comes back about a week and a half later, by which stage the students have actually lost interest in what they're doing and you start to go through that process again. And the editing is incredibly fussy. So from that point of view, celluloid, the replacement of digital for a celluloid is a much easier for both a teaching tool and I suspect for most amateur or non-professional filmmakers.
For like kind of older films and that, like you get a grittier look, kind of gives that, you can sometimes like, you know, you see grains on the film and that, so it kind of gives it that unique look about it.
Well, I think you just get a better look than digital. Digital's the quality's just not there, but with film, when all the older films are like Rocky and stuff like that, you just get this better quality.
As a maker, obviously, two things. One is the sheer speed of editing, and that's obviously got a major benefit. When you're editing with digital, you try something out, if it doesn't work, you just undo it and do it again. If you're editing with celluloid, you really need to know in advance exactly what you are doing, because you're actually physically cutting the celluloid and sticking it together. If you get the edit wrong, you've got to kind of undo it and do all over again physically, and that's really, really hard. I think the consequence of that is you produce things which are not so very well edited. If it's done professionally, obviously you will have more than one print and you can play around with it that way. From a shooting point of view, the major advantage obviously is cost and reshooting. Again, with celluloid, when you're shooting film, every time you stop shooting, if you do another take, it costs you money because the film's actually costing you money. Temptation, therefore, is to always stick with your first take. And that's a mistake, I think. I think you've got to sort of have that ability to go back and back again. So yes, from a practical point of view, it's much, much better to be using digital for shooting and for editing purposes.
Well, it's definitely a lot cheaper, and yeah, it's just like the price. You can get a good camera for about £100, so.
I think it can go a lot further now because like, it's sort of taken over. It can just, what you can do with it in the future, which I think will overcome the quality issue.
Yes. Now, here I'm not sure what level we're talking about, but if we're talking at the level of experiencing the film as a viewer, then what I've said before almost, I can say the reverse. Personally, I think the quality of celluloid as an image to view is much better. Now, I think that is because I was brought up on celluloid. I'm used to watching celluloid. And when I go to the cinema now, I do still feel I'm seeing a slightly inferior product. Maybe in 10 years' time, that will have gone, and I won't even notice that. And I notice when I go to the cinema, and I kind of make a comment to my wife, she says, "What are you talking about? I've got no idea. It all looks the same." So maybe it's just me being one of the old guards, and that's what it is. But yeah, so I think the format does make a difference. But it's such that there's so many other things that you're looking at when you're watching a film. You're listening to the dialogue. You're listening to the story. You're excited by the speed of the film. It probably is only some films where the sheer quality of what the film looks like makes a big difference. And that's probably films which have a larger scale, maybe historical films, maybe big dramas, maybe a big western or something like that, maybe even science fiction films. So you get that kind of sense about the feel matters. But maybe for a low budget digital film, maybe it doesn't make that much difference.
Not particularly. I mean, probably if you're using digital, you're probably going to be adding effects in and that, so it's a bit easier for editing and like adding in CGI. So yeah.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, like, if you film on celluloid and then put it through a digital projector, you lose something of the quality. But if you just have film on film, you get the full image.
Oh, I think they give you a range of experience. I mean, I think one of the things I find interesting, I was looking at some figures the other day, which suggested to me the average person in the country sees 88 films a year, which is a lot. If you go back to the heyday of cinema, people on average watched, now what's the figure, 26 films a year. In other words, they would watch a film every fortnight. That was a regular pattern, and that was a great day. But then you couldn't see film in any other format. So what you have, therefore, is people having more and more and more film experiences. Now, I suspect my viewing habits are much heavier than the national average, because I'm sort of quite addicted to film on whatever format. But I will make a decision about whether I want to see a film on a television format, whatever that is, as against that. But it doesn't mean I can get to the end of the day and I'm thinking, well, what is there? What can I see on the iPlayer? And I'll be watching sort of stuff I probably wouldn't watch any other way. So yes, the experience is we watch more films, and from my point of view, it's not an alternative. As far as I'm concerned, I probably go to probably as many films in the cinemas I ever went to. I just see more films.
Yes.
I'd say to some extent, yeah, but like cinemas normally get the release first, so if people really want to go see a film urgently, then they will go to the cinema to watch it first. So it's probably taken a slight hit, but not too drastically.
Yeah, definitely, because like you can just sit there at home just watching Netflix all day, watching whatever. But with cinema, you're still going to go cinema because it's something to do. It's a day out to get out of the house.
Since many of the opinions I've captured within this documentary are all mainly towards digital, mostly because digital is much cheaper and lets directors do a lot more when it comes to shooting and editing their film. Digital is relatively new to some directors, including Spielberg and Tarantino, as they both were. Some may argue that digital does not give the movie justice in terms of quality and picture. In my opinion, if I were a director in the film industry, I would personally shoot my film on digital, only because digital offers much more opportunity in terms of making the film the best it can be. It's low budget and you can do a lot with it.